Afternoon, folks. Grandpa Greenwald here. This afternoon, we're going to make some stewed chicken. So let's go ahead and get started with that. I bought some pre-seasoned, it's this barbecue season, leg quarters. And I'm going to cut these leg quarters up. We don't need leg quarters per se in here, but we do need the legs and thighs. So let's go ahead and get some started. I'm going to get this induction cooker cooking. So let me go ahead and put a medium low and stir it on that. About 175 degrees we have it started out at. So let me go ahead and cut these leg quarters and see if we can... There you go. There's 10 pieces of chicken there. And we'll get this preheated and see if we get some of that in the pan to start it cooking. We're not going to overcrowd the pan, so if this is all we end up cooking, yeah, that's perfect. We can do that. So we had to reorganize a little bit. I came back with a stand. Today I was out searching around and I found this really nice crate here to bring my cooking up to a more comfortable level on my back. And I found a new cutting board, and overall I'm tickled to death. All righty. Let's go ahead and start laying some of this the chicken down in here. Like I said, this was already, it was seasoned, seasoned at the supermarket. So there's no sense taking that season off. It's a Southwestern season. It goes along with our theme that wow, fun stuff. Anyway, we're going to be adding some green chilies to this in the end, or later on we're going to add some green chilies, so this will just play right into that. All righty, let's let's get started here. We're going to come back, we're going to turn, we're going to put the lid on, we do all kinds of things. Let's let her go. All righty, let's see where we're at here. There's been a lot of sizzle going. Oh, yummy, yummy, yummy. Wow. I'll try to get this other little one down in here. We'll see if we get this all cooked. Alrighty. Got a new 12-inch made in USA vintage lid for my 12-inch skillet here. So we'll let that just sizzle a little bit. Let it steam and sizzle. And I'll go ahead and rinse this. Just go inside, rinse this cutting board a little bit. We'll be back and take another look. All righty, let's see what do we got with this chicken here. I'll take that off. All right, I'm going to take this off. Partially done through and through. It's certainly not all the way done, but we're going to put it back in and cook it in the gravy. So we want to get it brown, let some goodness come out of the chicken. Look at that, yummy, yummy, yummy. That's really nice piece of chicken there. Oh, yeah. You just want to jump into it like it is here. And get some veggies in here cooking. Get those smooth around. We'll pick up that goodness slowly out of the bottom of the pan. Put us about that much. How much garlic pieces? And we'll saute these. Stir these vegetables around and get them sauteed really nice, and we'll start building our moving up some of this broth from the bottom, and or some of the goodness from the bottom. You have the little bit of moisture, and it's just pulling it and lifting it. I think I have the camera's position where you can actually see that in the. In the bottom of the pan, what's going on there? Flour scoop. A little flour. Everything lifting up. The skillet's as clean as it could be right now down there. I don't know what that was in there. It was just a piece of the broth, I guess. Looking pretty good there. I'm going to continue to work this bottom a little bit and let our flour thicken up a little bit more. We're going to put a lot more broth in there. So I might even have to add some more roux to keep it thick. But it's looking really good here. Let me add just a little bit more. Gonna have enough roux to make the gravy. Need the gravy. All right, let that set for just a little bit, and we'll be back. All righty, it's time to put the rest of the goodness in the pan. Oh yeah. Slow down, Dave. Get this baby's down in there cooking. Let me do something else here before I cover myself up. Make sure that this is perfect. Nothing wrong with that broth. We'll go ahead and add the rest of that. Press that broth in. I probably should have done that before I put the chicken, so I can kind of move it around and mix it up, but it'll work itself out. It will work itself out, video. So we have the goodness that ran out of the chicken. We'll dump that in there also. Miss Sherry, I hope you like mushroom. I'm just going to take some mushrooms and put them around. Can you guess what the last ingredient is? Or actually, we have two more here. Two more. I need to add a little something there. And I can dump more mushrooms later. Just wanted to get in there because this is going to be a mushroom gravy. So we need to make it mushroomy. The last thing that I want to put in, and we're kind of overloading here. I think we're going to be okay. Oh, my friend Pamela brought this pan mint there from all the way from Canada. All righty. We're just going to lay some green chilies on top. Well, I think I was bragging about peeling green chilies a few weeks back. Let's see. These are the chilies that we peeled that day. We had them in the freezer, and like I said, we'll be using them. We have put away some more also, so we'll be using these quite a bit. All right, David. Kind of overdid it. But I think we're okay. If I have to come back with a big spoon and scoop a little bit, that's what I'll do. Let's taste this, baby. Oh, my goodness. Whoa, perfect like it is. Wait till it pulls up all these mushrooms and green chilies and the goodness from the rest of that chicken. It's going to be fabulous. I'm going to let it sit just like it is. Let's see. We all have a chance to cook in that yummy gravy. Well, you folks, y'all remember I was trying to force that extra piece of chicken into the pan? Say yes, you remember that. I had to take it out. It was causing when the moisture came out of the chicken, the extra moisture that was still in the chicken, it made for too much broth. Anyway, I ended up taking that one. Chicken thigh out of there, and everything is just stabilized. It's just sitting there cooking, and we'll give it as long as we need to, or as long as we want to. It's just getting better and better every minute it sits there. All righty, folks, that just about got this stewed chicken done. The other thing, actually, we have one more ingredient also, but I haven't brought that out yet. Maybe we will, maybe we won't. We're going to add a can of Del Monte fresh cut sweet peas. Again, a lot of people, or maybe normally this is eaten on the side. I like to put my peas right in there when I dip this out and put it on rice. This gravy is so good. You could eat this gravy from the with a bowl of rice or a pot of rice. You could eat this gravy from the time you get out of bed until you go back to bed. And maybe if you had enough, that might be about 10 o'clock in the morning. But it's really that good. I'm going to get, it's probably enough peas. I don't have to put the whole can. But let me taste this. They were still bubbling there. This fire is just precious. Well, nice. I'm going to let it turn it up. I headed it down to 210 degrees, let it simmer so that chicken got cooked. I'm going to go ahead and turn it up to 220, get it cooking a little bit heavier, let this some of this broth evaporate. Lots of juice came out of that chicken, so it's getting better and better and better. Yummy, yummy, yummy. Get in my tummy. One step that I did neglect to get did neglect to show is that a lot of that chicken fat cooked off the skin while we were there. So what we're going to do is just around the edges, go around the edges and dip the edges a little bit and see if we can, there's a bunch over here, see if we can pick up some of that chicken fat there. Not bad at all, but it's a, you know, kind of a good touch to make your meal, have a yummy, yummy, yummy meal, take what you need out of the bird, but don't take as much bad stuff. All righty, we did that. The last thing that we have to do with this is we're going to add a little bit of gumbo filet. That just kind of tops it off, blends things together for my taste, and we let that cook in. It really picks up that sassafras flavor. All righty. That is it. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you really like the video, hit the subscribe button. Come back and see some more. Success. Success. Big success. Boom.